And today marks 80 years since the attack on Pearl Harbor. It killed 2,300 Americans and launched the country into World War II. Now, to commemorate this day, what you're seeing right there on your screen is a large group of singers, right? Well, part of that group, a West Michigan singing group, traveled to Hawaii to share the gift of song with survivors, veterans, and visitors on the island. The Grand Rapids chapter of the Sweet Adelines. We've had them right here in the studio. Yeah, they were one of 10 groups and the only one from Michigan invited to perform at the 80th anniversary Pearl Harbor commemoration concert series. Clips of their performance, in case you missed it, will be posted on their Facebook page.
What an honor for them.
Right?
Congratulations. A sale is in the work for what many of us know as the Bob, short for Big Old Building in downtown Grand Rapids. According to real estate broker Ray Kaiser, both the Bob and 20 Monroe Live have sales pending, and all we know about who is making those purchases, that they are, quote, similar but different buyers. The broker working these two sales says they are expected to close by January, at which point we may know more about who is buying the buildings and what they plan to do with them. Similar but different buyers would be us, but it's not us.
Well, we're not buying Bob.
We are not.
are you sure?
Our offer was
denied.
But I
heard the price was $19.57.
Exactly.
Hey, the Kirtland's Warbler. Have you heard of that bird?
Yes.
A long-standing symbol of conservation here in the Mitten State. And now it's going to be featured on the state's new license plates to help raise money for wildlife habitat. Starting next month, Michiganders can purchase the plate through the Secretary of State for $35. $25 of that $35 is going to the Non-Game Fish and Wildlife Trust Fund. The DNR chose that species because it was removed from the federal endangered species list in October of 2019.
Well, today is a sweet day. It's National Cotton Candy Day. Are you yay or nay for cotton candy?
Spun sugar, I'll eat it, I'll eat it, give it to me.
Ugh. It's the staple of carnivals, fairs, and the circus, but it hasn't always been called cotton candy, though. People have called it spun sugar, candy floss, and fairy floss. To mark the day, you can enjoy some cotton candy and post a social media hashtag National Cotton Candy Day. And some fun facts about this, ironically, though, okay? A dentist and confectioner actually teamed up to an event machine that spun all this cotton candy back in 1897. It's believed that another dentist later came up with the name cotton candy. That's, makes my teeth hurt just looking at that.
So a dentist came up with that, huh?
Right. Yeah. Well, he had to stay in business.
That's called job security. That's called job security.
Yes.
After that, yeah. Hey, a German family has quite a festive way to celebrate the Christmas season. Look at this house. Yeah. Is there room for anything other than trees? Because that's all you got in there. This year, the Jeromans, I'm going to go with Jeromans, sure. They've outdone themselves. 444 decorated trees, that's up from the 420 they had last year. The family was even presented a certificate from the German Record Institute. I'm assuming that's their version of the Guinness.
Mm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The most decorated Christmas trees all in one place. It's not so much the trees that I'm thinking about, it's the power bill.
Yeah, there's that. Now, remember, I told you I've been really struggling getting the tree up this year.
Yeah.
I did put one up yesterday.
Did you go get your tree?
No, it's 3 feet tall. It goes in Bronson's room.
Is it real?
No, it's fake.
Okay, it's fake.
But that's where we're at so far.
That's
I'm going to buy a different one today. Today is the day.
Okay, you said that yesterday.
Yes. All right.